Chrissy!
The Chrissy? The Chrissy?
The dance has been skyrocketing in popularity.
Can't wait to see the Chrissy on the show.
This has gone too far. It's my dance. You're not allowed to take it.
Cory, Chrissy didn't take anything away from you.
Dance with Cory.
That girl loves dancing with her big brother.
Let's get down.
Now streaming on Netflix for preschoolers is the new animated series, Go, Go, Cory Carson. And here to talk about the show is their creators, Alex Woo and Stanley Moore. Good morning.
Good morning. We're doing well. How are you?
I'm doing great. Thanks for talking to me today. So how are things going in Bumberton Hills?
It's doing well. It's doing well. There is a big talent show happening today. And Cory and Chrissy are entering it. We have this premiere of our first mini movie of the series, premiering on Netflix today.
That's right. Roll Train, the new talent show where the Chrissy dance is taking America by storm.
That's right. Yeah. So the story is actually about this talent show that Cory and Chrissy enter. Cory invents this dance and he calls it the Cory. And he and Chrissy perform it on stage in front of the town. But Chrissy performs it a little bit more adorably than Cory does. As she becomes the fan favorite, everybody starts calling the dance the Chrissy instead of the Cory. And Cory sort of has to deal with this and figure out, I'm happy that my sister's getting the credit, but I actually really invented the dance and they're calling it by the wrong name. So it's a really great, heartfelt episode.
Now, guys, I've been reading in the trade papers, Daily Variety and Hollywood Reporter. It seems Corey's a little upset that his dance was stolen, and he's thinking of legal action against his sister.
No. Those are all just rumors. We can put those to rest right now.
What I really enjoy about your show is that there's something for adults. You know, parents can watch this show with their kids and get jokes that you are aiming at them. So the kids have something to watch, and then, you know, I was watching Roll Train take off on Soul Train. I was dying. So I'm glad you included, you know, something for adults as we watch it, something for parents.
Thanks for saying that. That's really important in everything that we make. And it's one of the big lessons we took with us from our time at Pixar is that you're not just making content for children, you're making content for everyone. So even though this is technically a preschool series or targeted at a younger demographic, we wanted to make a show that we were laughing at as well. So whenever we're crafting these stories and crafting these jokes, we don't say, oh, it's funny enough for kids. We want to make sure that there's something there for us and that we're laughing as the creators.
So creating an animated series for preschoolers, did you bring any kind of educational experts in as advisors?
You know, surprisingly, we don't. It might be a good idea, but we actually... we actually just draw from our own lives. I think, you know, we very much feel like, you know, it's our job as the, you know, experts in the medium to show people what's possible with storytelling, what's possible with cinema. We really try to just think about the stories that we want to hear, that we want to see. And we draw from our own personal experiences, my own childhood, Stanley's childhood, his experience as a parent, his child's experience. So we observe a lot. I guess the only experts that we consult are really ourselves and our team.
So when I was a kid, I used to ride the People Mover in Tomorrowland at Disneyland all the time. And at the end of the ride, they were sponsored by Goodyear. And they'd always say, go, go, Goodyear. Go, go, Cory. So automotive, is there kind of a subliminal message there?
No, we didn't know that. And we don't want to get sued for anything. So we never knew about that. there's a toy line called the Go-Go Smart Wheels. And we actually partner with them in the creation of this. So the Go-Go comes from the Go-Go Smart Wheels.
So tell me about casting the voices for the series. They all seem like perfect matches.
Yeah, we have been so lucky. We found amazing, amazing voice actors. And so much of it was just plain luck. So the voice of Cory is actually my neighbor's cousin. When we met him, he was 8 or 9 years old. And we were putting this pitch together for the show to take it out to all these different studios and networks to see if they'd be interested in it. And so we put together a little proof of concept, like a 1 minute sort of teaser piece. And we needed a kid voice. And so I just asked some of my friends and my neighbors, hey, do you guys know anybody, like a kid that has a really cute voice? And my neighbor said, oh, my cousin has a pretty like cute, raspy voice. And I can send you, you know, his info and he can send you an audition. So he sent us this little voice memo that he recorded on his iPhone. And the minute we heard it, we were like, oh, that's our kid. That's Cory. And he had never acted before in his life. And so, yeah, when we pitched this to Netflix and they heard that voice, they're like, who is that kid? We're like, you got to get him. And fortunately, he was like game to be the voice for the entire series. So, yeah, we've just been so lucky. All of our actors are from the Bay Area. We hire local talent. And so many of the kids have just never acted before. They're just being kids, which is, I think, why they sound so sincere and authentic.
I have a nephew who's in preschool right now. His name is Lincoln, and he's all about Paw Patrol. But maybe you can get him to watch Go, Go, Cory Carson.
All right, Lincoln. That's enough Paw Patrol, all right? You hear us? No, I'm just kidding. Paw Patrol's a great show, too. But you should check it out, Lincoln. It's a fun show. I think you'll like it.
Guys, thank you so much for talking to me today. Congratulations on the new series on Netflix, and I wish you the best of luck.
Thanks so much.
Thank you. It was wonderful talking to you. Thanks again.
You can catch Go Go Cory Carson on Netflix, and also you can check out more reviews and interviews on my website at VegasFilmCritic.com. I'm Jeffrey K. Howard in Las Vegas. Thank you for joining me. I'll see you next time.